If you saw some of my older kids, they did not have this Teflon bearings here.
So is it?
Have everybody reached?
Yes, sir.
Everybody is there in the hall?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, when I invert this kit, none of the drills fall. If you saw my earlier kit, they were having these white rings here. The drills were very loose there. Now, these are Teflons. So everything fits with friction inside, yeah? So it remains stable. What does the kit contain? The kit will contain four drills. DOS 1, DOS 2, black ring. Here the yellow ring is gone, because it's all worn out also. But anyway, when you look at the drill, you can make out the thinnest one is yellow. The yellow ring is disappeared from here. The second one is black, a 3.7 implant, 4.1 implant, and 5 implants. So the thinnest, second, third, fourth, DOS 1, 2, 3, 4. Then they have got these markings, okay, 8, 10, 12, 14. These are titanium drills, and I think they last you easily. I think 100 implants is not a problem really with this. The only drill that you really need to replace in any kit, whether it is Leone or whether it is the KOS, is the primary drill, the yellow drill. If your yellow drill stops, because you use it for every single implant procedure. So if your yellow drill stops cutting, order a new yellow drill. As you go wider, you use very few. The green ones, you use fewer 4.1 ones. So they last you much longer. So the four drills, DOS 1, 2, 3, 4 is in the kit. Then in your kit is two spiral drills, 2 and 2.8. Now you saw today morning the implant placement of the BCS implant. And BCS implants have only the spiral screws only at the apical end. So compulsorily, whenever you're using BCS implant, after using the DOS implant for the complete depth, you will use the spiral drill. You will use the 2mm spiral drill when you're using a 3.5mm implant, and you will use a 2.8mm spiral drill when you're using the 4.1 implant. Then, in your drill, our placement aids. So we showed you two placement aids will be there, one for KOS and the BCS implants, another for the KOSK or the ball implant. You will see that tomorrow. And I showed you that you have a vertical slot on the side of the drill in case it gets stuck with a high compression bone. If the implant has the placement aid has gone over the implant abutment, then just put a scalar in the vertical slot and just do the leverage, it comes out. The drill has definitely, we showed you the one drill extension. Drill has a ratchet. And drill has four bone expansion screws, 3, 3.7, 4.1 and 5. Never fight with the bone. Use the bone expansion screw. If your compressions are going over 40 to 45 newton centimeter, the implant insertion is not complete. Supposing you are placing an implant and it's 90-95% complete, okay, and it's going tighter than 45 newtons, are you going to remove the implant? Of course not. You would complete the insertion. However, in very hard marble cortical bone, if your implant is only one-third inserted or less than half inserted and it's getting very hard over for size so that it can cut the threads into the bone, and then your bone implant, a very hard bone, the implant is going extra.